Good afternoon and welcome to the Midday News. Here's what we have in the bulletin. Tragedy in Westmoreland. Police investigate couple's murder. Police shooting renewed call, school shooting renewed calls for heightened security measures. And later in sports, West Indies top group staged at ICC T20 World Cup with perfect record. Thank you for joining us. I'm Shamela Pula and here are the details. We begin this afternoon with a developing story. There was chaos at the Negril police station in Westmoreland where a short while ago, a woman believed to be a UK national killed herself. According to reports, the woman had been displaying suicidal intentions. TVJ News understands that earlier today, she was attempting to jump to her death from the property where she was staying. However, her body was retrieved at the beach of another property. It's understood that she was taken to the police station out of concern. She asked to use the restroom, and upon realizing she had not come out after some time, the police went to investigate. It was revealed that she strangled herself with the belt of her bathroom robe. By the time medical officers arrived to the scene, she was pronounced dead. We will have more on this developing story in subsequent newscasts. Still in Westmoreland, the police are investigating the murder of a couple this morning. According to reports, at about 5 o'clock, the Jamaica Fire Brigade responded to a blaze in Contact District, Williams Field. Following the cooling down exercise, the remains of the couple were found. They are believed to be in their 50s. Several spent shells were also found on the scene. There are renewed calls for heightened security at schools across the island after yesterday's shooting at Ocherius High School. The Jamaica Teachers Association and the National Parent Teachers Association of Jamaica weighed in on the incident on Power 106 Tuesday.
A 12-year-old student remains in hospital after she was shot in the thigh by a 14-year-old male student. The teen, who is in custody, brought the Glock pistol to school to show his classmates when it accidentally discharged. The police have seized the weapon and are investigating its origin. The incident has raised concerns about students having easy access to firearms.
This is a very uncomfortable space to be in at this moment. Our heart goes out to both parents. The youngster who fired the trigger and the child who got hit by that bullet. And it could have been fatal, and we thank God that didn't happen. But I think we're going to have, and I think President Johnson and his team, along with ours, and all the stakeholders in the school system, education system, should be very busy this summer, because we cannot go into September with this fear.
The Ocherius High School shooting has also brought into focus the issue of school safety.
I can't speak to the processes that took place there, but what I can indicate is that by and large, the processes that take place at schools are in many regards similar. So there are security guards there. In many respects, students are searched either on a whole-scale basis or randomly. We know that the deans of disciplines, sometimes supported by members of the security forces, when called and when they are available, they do assist schools in carrying out these spot checks and searches.
Education officials, parents and stakeholders are urging the government to implement additional safety measures in schools.
There has to be a total revamping of what is considered security in school. And both political parties and their campaign cheer for the next election. Slow down a little bit and take some time and look at safety in schools. Think about the September term coming up and what both of you are going to do to keep our children in our schools safe.
Kerrion Simpson, TVJ News.
Opposition spokesman on education, Senator Damon Crawford, is standing firm on his proposal to increase the education tax. Senator Crawford says this is necessary to protect students. He was speaking on TVJ Smile Jamaica Tuesday.
The opposition spokesman on education, Damien Crawford, is proposing a 1 percentage point increase in the general consumption tax, GCT, to boost funding for the education sector. He contends that the move aims to tackle the long-standing underfunding of education. Currently, the education sector is getting $161 billion in funding. However, Mr. Crawford says at least 80% of this amount is allocated towards salaries and utilities, leaving a mere 20% for meaningful investments in the sector.
So much so that the schools are receiving 17,000 Jamaican dollars per child at the high school level and 11,000 Jamaican dollars per child at the primary school level. This is for the year. Now, if you do that simple mathematics, it would mean in a 10-month school year, that is $1,700 per month. And if they are doing 20 days, you will see that that is about $85 per day. So the truth is that that isn't incapable of funding education.
Citing a World Bank study on Jamaican children, Mr. Crawford warned that the current state of affairs will have negative consequences for the country's future.
The World Bank says that the Jamaican student is approximately 53% of their full potential had they gotten proper education and good health care. And additionally, a child who pays 11 years of bus fare, 11 years of lunch money, 11 years of uniform is getting effectively 7 years of education.
Gotcha.
So when we look at that, we say that we need additionally about $25 billion more to appropriately and properly fund the education system.
Mr. Crawford is aware that the proposal is facing opposition, even from within his own party, but he says a bold action to address the crisis in education is needed.
Therefore, $10 billion per is now being additionally spent in the Ministry of Security. However, some people may frown on $25 billion to be spent. So if we don't spend it on children eating in school, we'll spend it on prisoners eating in prison.
Yes.
And that is 3 meals per day versus the 1 meal per day that I'm calling for. If we don't increase the boarding facilities within our schools, we will increase the boarding facilities in our prison. Because if we can't separate some of our children from the community, if we can't reduce the what is called chronic absenteeism up to 21 days because of affordability, because of distance from school and cost of travel, we're going to be in a problem.
Nekinski Robinson, TVJ News.
Councillors in Portmore St. Catherine want an audit and plan to tackle underperforming citizens' associations. The issue was discussed at the recent Municipal Corporation meeting. Krista Campbell reports.
At the latest Municipal Corporation meeting, Portmore Mayor Leon Thomas was the first to voice concerns about the operation of some citizens' associations in the municipality.
There are some community groups never have a meeting, still not have a meeting, but they are representative from the community that is a part of the Joint Citizen Association. There are some active citizen association where the member is now sitting on the joint committee, which the community, the citizen association did not recommend anybody from the community to be a part of it.
He said that was based on his own investigations and urged the Social Development Commission, SDC, which has oversight of the associations, to hold the non-performing groups to greater accountability.
If the group has a constitution, if the group is meeting, if the group has an elected executive, if the group is having minutes by agenda, if the group has a treasurer's report, those are some of the things that we determine if the group is functional.
Person can meet face-to-face, the SDC could set up some paid Zoom platform where these community groups can have access to. You schedule them and they can use it. Maybe they can't pay for a dedicated Zoom link where to accommodate the number of persons.
And the SDC has its own concerns, even as one councillor highlighted challenges with governance at the Westchester Citizens Association.
A former president stepped down and the vice president took over, vice president of dying, and then you just automatically see somebody appear on paper to say they are the president.
We have in place instances where groups have an interim executive to carry the operation of the group until an AGM is held where a full election is held. So sometimes there are some groups that will have an interim, which is a temporary situation. Now, another challenge is that there are groups that you have presidents for life where persons do not want or do not welcome the AGM.
AGMs, or annual general meetings, act as some measure of accountability by outlining issues raised in minutes taken each year and allowing citizens to elect their own executive body for their associations. Krista Campbell, TVJ News.
It's time for a break. Stay with us. More stories when we return. Welcome back to the Midday News. In response to the growing worries about the lack of space to bury the dead in St. Catherine's Spanish Town, Mayor Norman Scott says plans are advanced for the construction of a new cemetery.
Within a couple of days, I'll be signing a contract to acquire 3.5 acres of land up in Yorktown to have another cemetery established in Yorktown.
Meanwhile, the mayor spoke about plans for a new industrial belt in Spanish Town.
Quite a number of the top companies in Jamaica are coming out there. Banks are coming there. Warehouses are coming there. Other forms of businesses are coming there. So it is going to be the Spanish Town rebirth.
It's now time for the Business Minute.
LATAM, the largest airline in Latin America, is to begin operating non-stop flights between Lima, Peru and Montego Bay, Jamaica on December 1 this year. The Ministry of Tourism says the flights will be operated 3 times per week, utilizing 2 planes, with a capacity for 144 and 174 seats. Senior advisor and strategist in the Ministry of Tourism, Delano Sievright, says the airline is expected to facilitate connections with Peru's national network, as well as with other countries in South America. McDonald's has announced that it will be pulling the plug on its AI-powered ordering technology. According to reports, the computer isn't reliable at recognizing some accents. It's understood that AI technology has not been able to distinguish voices from background noises. McDonald's rolled out the technology at more than 100 drive-thrus. It was part of a deal with IBM. Despite the development, the company says it will still work with the tech giant. The restaurant is hoping it has a better automatic ordering system to try out by the end of this year. And that's it for the Business Minute. I'm Hal Shane Burke.
Time now for the top regional and international stories.
In the region, an earthquake with a magnitude of 4.0 shook Trinidad and Tobago's capital, Port of Spain, but no injuries or damage were reported. It comes 6 days after a 4.1 magnitude quake was felt in the Twin Island Republic and St. George's, Grenada. On the international scene, more than 1,000 firefighters have been called in to battle a fire in Los Angeles County, with more on the way. This as a wildfire has forced hundreds of people to evacuate and has burned its way through more than 15,000 acres since it started Saturday. High temperatures, low humidity, and strong winds are fueling the blaze, prompting officials to urge residents to stay vigilant and be prepared for possible evacuations. And Thailand will become the first nation in Southeast Asia to legalize same-sex marriage after the kingdom's Senate approved a marriage equality bill on Tuesday, with supporters calling it a monumental step forward for LGBTQ+ rights. This move, praised by LGBTQ+ advocates, positions Thailand as a progressive and inclusive country following Taiwan and Nepal in legalizing same-sex marriage in Asia. And those were the top regional and international stories. I'm Nakinski Robinson.
We head to a quick break. When we come back, we'll have your midday sports report.